Good morning and welcome to our Youth and Children's Service for Sunday 23rd of August. Now, a couple of weeks ago, we looked together at the story of Abram and God's promise to Abram and how God changed his name from Abram to Abraham. We're going to do the next bit of the story, which is the story of Abraham and Isaac. And we're going to be looking at great swaps today. So have you ever been involved in a great swap deal? And we're going to look at how the swap deal with God swapping a lamb in the place of Isaac and later swapping Jesus in our place are some of the greatest swap deals in history. So before we do that, we're going to remind ourselves that Jesus, light of the world, is with us. So if you've got a candle at home, you can maybe light it now. Join in with this prayer. So Daniel's going to light our candle for us. So we pray, Lord Jesus, light of the world, we ask you to come and be with us this morning and just to be in our midst. And you promise, Lord, where two or three are gathered, there you are. And I just thank you, Lord, that you just animate and light our lives. In Jesus' name. Amen. So for our first game this morning, I need you to find six identical cups or tubs like we've got here, and you're going to place them in a formation. Then you're going to find either a ball or a coin. This will work with a coin. And you're going to place it under one of the mugs. So I'm going to place it under this mug here. Then what we're going to do is we're going to swap some of the mugs around. And you might want to do this several times. And we're going to keep swapping them and try and really confuse the people that you're playing with. And once you've carried on doing that a few times, we're going to keep swapping them, keep swapping them. And then we're going to say to the boys, boys, which mug do you think the ball is under? You get one guess each. Isaac, turn over the mug, Daniel. It's not under that one, Isaac. And it wasn't under that one. And should we see, was it under this one? No. It was that one! Okay, at home, you might want to have a go. Find six identical cups, put a coin or a ball under them, swap them around a few times and see if you can confuse your parents. Enjoy. So today we're talking about amazing swaps. And the guy in the next video was an expert at swapping things. And in 2005, he started with a red paperclip and managed for a series of swaps to swap all the way up to a farmhouse. Now, that might sound unbelievable, but if you watch the next video, you'll be able to pick out some of the things that he swapped along the way. Now, after the video, I'd like you to have a little chat with your family. What is the best deal you've ever got through swapping? What did you swap and were you happy with the outcome?
first song this morning is Blessed Be Your Name by Matt Redman. And it's a great song talking about how we worship God both in the land that is plentiful and when we're found in a desert place. And the reason we included this morning is because in the bridge it's got this great line, you give and take away, you give and take away. My heart will choose to say, Lord, blessed be your name. So even though God is in control and sometimes we are given and sometimes we have things taken away, actually, we still say, blessed be God's name. So join in this morning, worship the Lord, and sing out to blessed be your name.
The Holy Tales.
Hello, my name is Tubby. I live here in this wonderful library, and I love to eat books. I live here with my friends, Gumbo and Freckles. Gumbo, Freckles, come out, wherever you are. Over there, on that great book, is Grand Old Holy. She is really old and wise, and tells us wonderful stories when she is awake, that is. Oh, and we love to sing.
Naughty bookworms, you are very lucky that I am awake today.
Hello, Holy. We cannot wait to hear another story from the Bible. Do tell us one.
Today, I will tell you the story of Abraham, his son Isaac, and how God tested his love. At the end of it, I will ask a question, so listen very carefully. A long time ago, there was a man named Abraham who loved God very much. God had blessed Abraham and promised to make him great. The land of Canaan was promised to him and his children. A few years had passed and God wanted to see if Abraham still loved him. So he came before Abraham and said,
Abraham, I want you to give me your son as an offering on Mount Moriah.
Abraham was scared because he loved Isaac very much, but he obeyed since he still loved and believed in God. So he took a donkey and two servants along with some chopped wood and his son Isaac up to the mountain. It took them 3 days to reach the mountain. After reaching the mountain, he told his servants to go and build an altar where he would offer his son to the Lord. Isaac, who had been watching all this, asked his father very innocently,
Father, I can see that you're about to make an offering to the Lord, but where is the lamb?
Abraham replied,
Don't worry, son. God will give us a lamb.
He then tied up Isaac and put him on top of the chopped wood. As he raised the knife to kill his son, an angel appeared. The angel said,
Wait, Abraham, do not hurt the child. The Lord just wanted to see if you still loved him. But now he knows that you would kill your only beloved son for him.
Abraham was grateful that the Lord had spared his son. When he looked up to thank the Lord, he saw a lamb. Abraham placed the lamb in the place of his son as an offering to God. Together, he and his son went back home happy. Okay, children, now for the question. What did God ask Abraham to do for him?
Let me answer this one. God asked Abraham to offer his son Isaac to him.
Very good, Gumbo. That is right.
Thank you. So at the end of July, the car that I drove, which was a blue Renault Scenic, died. Now this is a blue Toyota Yaris, so it's not a Renault Scenic, but it kind of looks a little bit like my old car. Now the clutch went, which meant that my car didn't really drive very fast. It wouldn't accelerate. It was all round a bit of a nightmare. The air conditioning didn't work, the windows didn't open, the radio didn't work. It was a bit of a nightmare. Now imagine I went to my friend at that moment, and my friend had a whole collection of cars, from super fast cars, down to family cars, down to small little cars. And I was just hoping that I could swap my old blue Renault Scenic for just one of his little cars, just to help us get around. And he said, sure, no problem. And he went into his garage and he brought back a set of keys. And it turned out that he was going to swap me, not for a little car, but for this red Ferrari right here. Now, potentially, you might have chosen a different car on this page, but imagine he was swapping for a Ferrari. How amazing would that be? My blue Renault Scenic that didn't really work swapped for a big, shiny, red Ferrari. How amazing would that be? Now, in today's story, there's an even more amazing swap. God asked Abraham to sacrifice his son, Isaac. Why? This might seem really strange to us, but the point is, Isaac was a gift from God. Abraham was 99 and his wife Sarah was 90 when they gave birth to Isaac. So God had given Isaac as a gift to Abraham with a promise that he was going to make Abraham's descendants as many as the stars in the heavens. Now, what God wanted to know is, did Abraham trust God, even with the life of Isaac? Now, Abraham did trust God. He might have been nervous, he might have been scared, but he took Isaac on a donkey with a couple of his servants, and they went up the mountain, and he was about to sacrifice Isaac when the angel of the Lord said, listen, do not harm Isaac. God will provide the lamb himself. And sure enough, Abraham looks up and there's a lamb caught in a thicket, and they're able to sacrifice the ram instead. Now, what an amazing swap deal. Abraham thought he was about to lose his son, and actually, all of a sudden, it swapped for this lamb that God has provided. Isn't that amazing? How overjoyed and relieved do you think Abraham would have felt to get his son back? But that's not even the most amazing swap deal in the Bible. Later on with Jesus, we have the Son of God come down to earth, and he comes to earth. Why? Well, it's because God is going to swap Jesus in our place and take the penalty that we deserve for all the many things that we do wrong. It's a bit like this. Imagine you're playing football at school and you kick the ball through the window and the headmaster comes out and he goes, who did this? And you know that it's you and you know that you're going to be in lots of trouble, and you trudge up to the headmaster's office. And the headmaster's really angry, but he can see that you're sorry. And so instead of putting you in detention for a week, the headmaster's son says, I'll take that punishment. And so he takes your place and you're free to go. That would be amazing, wouldn't it? Well, Jesus took the punishment we deserve for all the many things that we do wrong. Every time we're rude or disrespectful or fail to treat other people lovingly. And instead of us dying like Isaac, actually Jesus, who we call the Lamb of God, took our place on the cross. And we get to go free and still have that relationship with God. It's an amazing, amazing swap deal. And so what is our response? Well, two things. Firstly, to be grateful to God. Grateful to God for the swap that took place. And secondly, to try really hard to ask Jesus for help. To not do those harmful things that caused the damage in the first place. So maybe this week you can have a little reflect on how great that swap was, that Jesus took our place for all those things that we've done wrong. And maybe you can find a time this week to say sorry to God and ask God to help you to live better. God bless.
Our second song this morning is I Will Offer Up My Life by Matt Redman. And in our story today, we saw that Abraham was willing to offer up his life and the life of Isaac as a blessing to God. And so we are called too to offer up our lives as our worship to God. And so we sing I Will Offer Up My Life by Matt Redman.
So for the craft activity today, we are going to make Abraham's altar that he creates for Isaac from the story that we've listened to today. So you will need some lolly sticks or strips of card, some tissue paper, or again, just different coloured card that would represent fire, and some PVA glue. So as you can see here, I've got Isaac helping me. The first thing you need to do is get two of your lolly sticks or strips of card and just put glue on either end, and you're going to then layer them over with the next two lolly sticks or strips of card. And the idea here is that you are trying to build up in a sort of pyramid type fashion, where you just overlap and overlap, getting closer to the centre so that it looks like you've raised the fire pit. So once you've got the height that you want to use, once it's sort of come to a point in the centre, you need to put glue in the centre and then just stick it around your coloured card or tissue paper to create the sort of base of a bonfire. As you can see here, there's no particular arrangement, we're just sort of plonking it on, and then just add more glue depending on how much tissue paper or pieces of card you need to add to create the fire. So there you have it, our finished altar with the fire pit on there, ready, just like in Abraham, in the story of Abraham, ready for Isaac's sacrifice.
For our prayer time today, we're going to read the reflection called The Parable of a Bamboo. So I'm just going to read that for you. And we're going to be thinking about how much are we prepared to give to God of our lives, and to use our lives as a sacrifice to him. So The Parable of a Bamboo. Once upon a time, in the heart of a certain kingdom was a beautiful garden. Of all the dwellers of a garden, the most beautiful and beloved to the master of a garden was a splendid and noble bamboo. Year after year, bamboo grew yet more beautiful and gracious. He knew of his master's love, yet he was modest and in all things gentle. Often, when the wind came to revel in the garden, bamboo would throw aside his dignity. He would dance and sway merrily, tossing and leaping and bowing in joyous abandon. He would lead the great dance of a garden that most delighted his master's heart. One day, the master himself drew near to look at this bamboo with eyes of curious expectancy, and bamboo, in a passion of love, bowed his head to the ground in joyful greeting. The master spoke, "Bamboo, I would use you." Bamboo flung his head to sky in utter delight. The day of days had been growing, hour by hour, the day in which he would find his completion and destiny. His voice came low, "Master, I am ready. Use me as you want." "Bamboo," the master's voice was grave, "I would be obliged to take you and cut you down." A trembling of great horror shook Bamboo. "Cut me down? Me? Whom you, master, have made the most beautiful in all your garden. Cut me down? Oh, not that, not that. Use me for your joy, O master, but don't cut me down." "Beloved bamboo," the master's voice grew graver still, "if I don't cut you down, I can't use you." The garden grew still. Wind held her breath. Bamboo slowly bent his proud and glorious head. Then came a whisper, "Master, if you can't use me unless you cut me down, then do your will and cut." "Bamboo, beloved bamboo, I must cut your leaves and branches from you also." "Master, master, spare me, cut me down and lay my beauty in the dust, but would you take from me my leaves and branches also?" "Bamboo, alas, if I do not cut them away, I cannot use you." The sun hid her face. A listening butterfly glided fearfully away. Bamboo shivered in terrible expectancy, whispering low, "Master, cut away." "Bamboo, bamboo, I must divide you in two and cut out your heart, for if I do not cut, so I can't use you." "Master, master, then cut and divide." So the master of the garden took bamboo and cut him down and hacked off his branches and stripped his leaves and divided him in two and cut out his heart and lifting him gently carried him to where there was a spring of fresh sparkling water in the midst of the master's dry fields. Then putting down one end of broken bamboo into the spring and the other end into the water channel in his field, the master laid down gently his beloved bamboo. The spring sang welcome. The clear, sparkling water raced joyously down the channel of bamboo's torn body into the waiting fields. Then the rice was planted and the days went by. The shoots grew. The harvest came. In that day was bamboo once so glorious in his stately beauty, yet more glorious in his brokenness and humility. For in his beauty he was life abundant, but in his brokenness he became a channel of abundant life to his master's world. So, Father God, we just pray that we offer you our lives today. And Father, I just pray that you can help us to really think about what sacrifices we would make for the good of your kingdom. And Lord, we know that everything we have is a gift from you. And so I just pray, Lord, that we don't hold anything so tightly that we don't let it be used for your glory and your kingdom. And I pray that like the bamboo, that we can be humble to be used for your glory. In Jesus' name, amen.